So now our Boolean formula that we're building as an input to SAT is going to become even larger. So as you have seen before, the calculation that a non-deterministic RAM makes for a given input can be represented as a polynomial number of snapshots. And I'm now going to draw the snapshots only like this. You know that it represents the input, the program, and the read-write memory as well. What we've already seen is that the state of the non-deterministic RAM at each point in time can be represented as a snapshot. And that snapshot can be represented as a Boolean formula. So now that we found out how we can encode a snapshot into a Boolean formula, let's go back to our main mission, showing that any problem that can be solved on a non-deterministic RAM can be encoded as a SAT formula. And the idea of this is to build a huge, well, not that huge, it's still going to be polynomial size, but it's still going to be very large. So the idea is to build a very large Boolean formula as follows. Each time step of the algorithm is going to be represented as a snapshot. Then we're going to ensure that the first of these snapshots represents the memory of the RAM at t equals zero. What that means is that the program starts at the first line of execution, and of course that the memory contains the input that we're giving to that program or algorithm. Then, thirdly, we have to ensure that the snapshots fit together. What I mean by that is, even though it's a non-deterministic RAM, if at a certain point in time, say t equals x, it is in a certain state, then at the next time step, t at x plus 1, there's only a limited number of choices or potential states that machine can be in. So if we were having a deterministic RAM, actually, as we already said, the state of the machine at a time point x already clearly determines what state the machine will be in at point x plus 1. For a non-deterministic RAM, if you use the if better operation, then there can be two different states at the next time point. And then finally, we have to ensure that the Boolean formula that we're building as an input to SAT can only be satisfied if the algorithm returns yes at some point in time. Otherwise, because we have a decision problem, if the algorithm returns no, we do not want the Boolean formula to be satisfiable.